with Jmurrayathletics. We told you we would show you Schenectady, and we're going to show you Schenectady. Now, the hotel that you're going to see highlighted in one of the previous videos is actually over yonder, this way down the river. Right now, we are in the stockade area, which is very historic to Schenectady. Now, Schenectady was actually first settled in the year 1661. It was part of a Dutch colony of New Netherland. Arndt van Curler of Ninjkerk, Netherlands, and excuse me if I mispronounce that, granted letters to patent Schenectady in the year 1684. But then the Great Schenectady Massacre happened right here in this area of the stockade that occurred on February 8th of 1690. France and their Indian allies came in and burned much of this area. Over 60 people were killed in the incident. But nonetheless, we rebuilt. And by 1765, Schenectady was incorporated as a borough, and by 1798, it was chartered as a small city. Now, Schenectady covers roughly 209 square miles of land with a population of over 155,000 people as of 2020. Schenectady is also home to Union College, which was established in 1795, and Schenectady County Community College, which was established in 1967, which you will see later in this video. Is their music program. Construction for the original music program began in 1978, and by 1984, they were accredited by the National Association of Schools of Music, and in 2012, they actually built an entire new wing dedicated to the music program, which you will see later on. Now, this was actually built in the old Van Curler Hotel, which you will see when we show you the front of the building, and then it was obviously expanded from there. Let's check it out. Several different counties in the area about who was actually going to get it, and as you can see, Schenectady won that bid. So Rivers was opened on August 9th of 2009. It features your basic games like slots, poker, table games. They have a lovely to die for steakhouse in there called Duke's Chop House. Best steak I've ever had in my life. And they also have a market inside, and inside the market you can get products from Villa Italia, which is also another local Schenectady bakery that is to die for. And there's Johnny's To Go, which is another local Schenectady restaurant that you'll see when we hit downtown. Last thing to mention about this area is, along with the casino, they built the Landing Hotel in the back here, which is part of the casino. And then they also have all sorts of entertainment events in this area, such as Cage Wars. But prior to all this being a casino, this was the grounds of the old ALCO, which is the American Locomotive Company. And they worked very closely with GE, which we're going to talk about a little later. And a lot of the stuff from ALCO and GE is actually what helped the MTA down in the city to get many of the things that they needed. And we learned that when we visited the MTA Museum. Anywho, so that's pretty cool to know that this is where ALCO actually once was, but unfortunately business started to fizzle out for them in the 1960s, and that is why there is now a casino where that once stood. Particularly on Erie Boulevard, but they were kind of risque and vaudevillian type theaters, so he wanted something a little more upscale when Schenectady was booming. So he created Proctor's here, and we've had shows such as Hamilton and Stomp and Aladdin's Coming. We have actual shows from Broadway come here, which is pretty great. And the first show opened on December 27th of 1926, so this has been around for a long time. Much of that is because of General Electric.